good morning, everyone. I'm glad you're all here, and Merry Christmas to each and every one. Early this morning, there off the coast of the big island of Hawaii, the undersea volcano Lauihi had an earthquake at 1:31 a.m. local time, which 28 people have taken the time so far to report that they felt a magnitude 4.9. I got two different monitors where I'm taking the signature from. It is about 10,000 feet high and will one day be the newest island of the chain of the Hawaiian Islands. And it's about 3,000 feet, a little bit more, below sea level. One of the monitors, which was closer, isn't working. And the monitor on the left, which actually had the better signature, is way up over there. There's the location of the magnitude 4.9 earthquake. All the way up until the 1970s, they thought it was just a series of sea mounds that were from ancient eruptions that was no longer available. But after a series of earthquakes that occurred out there in that location, the Volcano Hawaii Observatory decided to do some investigation, and they found out, hey, it is an active volcano. In the past week, there's been 10 earthquakes in this location. The newest they have is a 2.9, 10 and a half kilometers in depth. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. And that would be that earthquake right there. There's other earthquakes. Let me make this bigger. I'll have to close this and make it bigger since then, but because they're so far, the monitors from where these earthquakes are being recorded, like there's one right here at 1533, that could be a 2.6 that recently occurred there on the Big Island itself. It comes in as a magnitude 2.38, so it probably is. I think October was the last time I did a report about all the earthquakes that are happening there in Hawaii. And this undersea volcano, along with Kilauea, Mauna Loa, it's all fed from the same hot spot. Think of a tree and all the branches that come up from a tree. And that's the newest thinking about how these volcanoes are being fed. Multiple branches rising up, yeah, and feeding the volcanoes. I found this article here. I'll give you a link. All these links will be down below in more information box. It has to be dated. It says if the hotspot theory is correct. Yeah, if the next volcano in the Hawaiian archipelago should form east or south of the island of Hawaii. Recent detailed mapping show Lauihi to be similar in form to Kilauea and Mauna Loa. Its relative flat summit apparently contains a caldera about 3 miles across. Two distinct ridges radiating from the summit are probably rift zones. So you can see the different locations of the rift going from north to south. Swarms of large earthquakes occurred in 1971, 1972, 1975, 84 through 85, 1990 through 91, and 1996. There was another swarm last year that would have been May of 2020 of over 100 earthquakes. Back in 1997, the Hawaii Observatory, working with Woods Hole, sent some equipment down there to monitor and see what was going on. They laid fiber optic cable and recording the different sounds that the volcano was making, but it didn't last long. Because of the damage to the fiber optics cable, they figured the cost would not be feasible to continue the exploration of this area. Yeah, it was an ancient volcano they thought was dead, and come to find out, yeah, it's not dead. It's evidently as large, and if not larger, than Mount St. Helens. Yeah, this webpage has not been updated since 2017, but they got images of pillow lava. And this other web page has not been updated since 2005, when they had an earthquake swarm of 100 earthquakes. The largest back then was a magnitude 3 and 4. In July and May of that year, there was a magnitude 5.1 and a 5.4. This 6.2, now that was in October of this year. This area also has hot thermal vents. This paper explains some of the hot thermal vents coming up. They average from 10 degrees Celsius, which is 50 degrees Fahrenheit, to 167 Celsius, which is about 332 degrees Fahrenheit. That's some hot water. Kind of reminds me of what's coming up there at Yellowstone. Like Yellowstone, there's microbial mats down there. And there's another paper showing the different types of sea life down there. But see, these are all report. This one report's from 2002, which is actually from the study they did in 1996. I really don't think they've done any recent research in quite a long time. I am sure a lot more than 28 people felt this earthquake. We got it all the way over to Hilo. Yeah, all the way south on the western side of the island. You can see the different reports. Did you feel this earthquake? You might have thought it was something else, one of the other earthquakes that often occur there on the island. If so, put those comments down below. And once again, Merry Christmas. Aloha. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. My family will be here to celebrate Christmas in about a half an hour. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.